Peierls and I went to Cambridge to discuss this with Chadwick and Goldhaber, which was very interesting. And Chadwick then said to the two of us, "And well, I bet you cannot make a theory of that." So there was a five-hour train trip back from Cambridge to Manchester, and during that train trip, Peierls and I solved the problem of the theory of this disintegration. And we then wrote a paper about that. Assumed, I think we had thought of that before, and I believe also Heisenberg had thought of that, that the range of the forces between neutron and proton, the nuclear forces, must be very short compared to the size of the deuteron. And that made it very easy to write down the wave function of the deuteron. In fact, we could write it down on the train still, and it's beautifully simple. And knowing that, we could also solve the problem of the scattering of neutrons by protons that was being experimented on. And we calculated that the cross-section for that scattering was very closely related to the binding energy of the deuteron. And from that we calculated that the cross-section should be about 3 × 10⁻²⁴ square centimeter. 10⁻²⁴ square centimeter is called a barn. For a nucleus, it's the cross-section as big as a barn, as one of my later colleagues at Cornell invented. And so we calculated 3 barns. The unfortunate thing, however, was that people did experiments on it, many of them at Columbia University, and they found about 20 barns instead of 3 barns. And the 20 barns was obtained even after Fermi had shown that there's a correction for the binding of the two deuterons in the molecule. The actual figure the experimenters had found was 50 barns, but Fermi's correction brought it down to 20. So obviously our theory of this scattering was very beautiful, but unfortunately wrong.